Hi, this is Bill Vantuono, Editor-in-Chief of Railway Age. We are at BNSF's Northtown Yard, the outdoor exhibits at Railway Interchange 2019. I'm here with Peter Jones of Greenbrier. He is Vice President International and Product Development. Yep. And behind us is the prototype of a 5,185 cubic foot or 5,185 covered grain hopper with a tsunami gate. This is the prototype, as I said. Peter, tell us about this new car and the features.
Okay. Well, the grain car is essentially very similar to a standard grain car that we see today. The big difference is that we have taken all of the area between the trucks and we've made that a compartment to store grain, and then we put a very large gate along the entire bottom of the car, which allows you to discharge the car significantly quicker or at the same speed we do today. It lowers the center of gravity of the car, so the car will ride better. But the big difference is, by putting all of that space between the trucks, we've been able to shorten the car. The car is 10% shorter than a standard grain car. So if you think BNSF today hauls typically 117 grain cars in a unit train, yes, we'll be able to get 129 cars in the same train length, which is very valuable for track space, passing loops, sidings, etc. They can haul the extra 12 cars per train without adding an additional locomotive, so no additional cost. Also, the car has significantly improved aerodynamics. We have a 53% drag reduction, so the car will ride more efficiently for the railroad, have a lower fuel burn. So we're very excited for all of these features, and we're hoping the car, the market, takes advantage of the car.
How quickly does the payload discharge with the tsunami gate?
Okay. As I said, it will discharge significantly quicker than a traditional grain car, but we're able to meter the gate and the discharge, so we've set the car to discharge at exactly the same rate as a current grain car, so we won't flood people's grain elevators. But if those agricultural businesses increase their takeaway systems, we can discharge as fast as they like. The car will discharge in under 30 seconds.
So what is the ideal sort of setup for loading that this car would function in?
So the car is really targeted for unit train grain distribution, large export terminals where they would be running unit trains around a loop track, and it would just go in and it would be eventually on an automatic discharge where it will be essentially like we've done with coal and aggregates today, that we've moved them so that the gates would open with a hot shoe. With this car, we can't use an electric hot shoe, we would, because of the dust environment, but we have a different type of trigger mechanism that could be used for unit trains of this. So I would say perhaps this is not the car for the mom and pop grain elevators. This is for big, high capacity operations. So we're targeting big grain elevators.
So what type of hot shoe, if it's not electric, how does that work?
Okay. I might keep that to myself, but it might be magnetic.
It might be magnetic.
It might be.
Okay.
We have a similar car running in our fleet in Europe, and we have a different technology that we haven't brought to the States yet.
So there is some synergy here between technology that was developed in Europe and here. Can you talk about that a bit?
Well, I'll just say it. Greenbrier, with our operations in Europe, we are the largest car builder in Europe, we're the largest car builder in South America, we're now neck and neck to be the largest car builder in North America. With our different fleets and different railroad environments, we're able to test things in different environments and benefit from different products in other countries. So we are bringing foreign technology to the US, we still go through the same AAR process to approve it, but we're able to test things in different environments.
Now, you mentioned that this car is rather aerodynamic. What features specifically give it that those advantages?
Okay, well, if you look along the bottom, a traditional grain hopper would have three large pockets, which are directly under the center sill. Here we have a large side that is very low to the ground. If you imagine a road truck and trailer setup, there's a large skirt that goes between the truck and the rear wheels. This kind of looks very similar. We've done a lot of modeling work with Boeing to calculate the aerodynamic efficiency of the car, and we've done this for several other car types, so we have some other cars coming to market that use similar techniques and benefits.
With Boeing, is there sort of wind tunnel testing involved?
No, we're actually able to simulate this with a technique called CFD, computational fluid dynamics. So a lot of the modeling work that is done to bring products to market faster in the aero business, we've applied to this car.
I would say that's rather innovative, wouldn't you?
We hope to continue to innovate beyond this. We've got more to come.
Well, Peter, thank you very much. It's good to be out here to see this in person.
Thank you, Bill.